All right, we're out here today doing a little test run with the boat. Been doing a lot of work with it. Just trolling some lures, doing a little slow troll with the trolling motor right now. Just keep it quiet for this video. A lot of people want to know how I troll lures, what speed, what colors. Of course, I'm not going to reveal all my colors, but one I started with that I liked the most, one of the best lures that I like, is a shad wrap, natural color. Fives, sevens work really good, and I go as high as nines. That's the biggest they make till you get into the X-wrap. I don't use lures that big, but what we do is usually I use a big motor. I usually troll between 3 to 3.5 miles an hour. I stagger lines. As you see right now, I've got just 4 lines out. I troll up to 7 lures off the back of the boat. Can be tricky. You get 2 or 3 fish on, you got to know where they're staggered, how your lines are put out. I always put my outside lines out the furthest, the center one in the middle, put it out the very farthest. I put it out first, I put the 2 sides out. You're going to have to feel your own distance that you want. Usually I'm around 75 on the sides, 100 in the middle. Then I stagger my first inside line, usually put it out 50 to 60 feet. Then the other one, bring it about 40 to 50 feet. And then these inside lines right here, that'd be 7. I run them real short, 25, 30 foot. And when the fish are aggressive, they're really aggressive, they'll come right up to the back of the boat and hit them. I catch a lot of fish letting the lure back out after I reel a fish in, letting the lure back out. Another thing, it is important, but not real important. When you're trolling lures, it's nice to have good electronics. It can tell you a lot about the fish. The fish are suspended up high in the water column. Usually when they're up in the water column, they're aggressive and they're feeding. If you see in a lot of fish down on the bottom, they're not aggressive. They're not really feeding. Best thing to do in that situation is try and spoon them. You get lucky and get one, entice them to bite. But back to like trolling lures. When I start doing more videos, I'll show you that electronics is not a key. I'll turn them off. Once I find the fish, so you don't need them. They're good to find the fish, but in the fall and in the winter, stripers and hybrids, they're moving around, they're feeding, they're fattening up, they're getting ready to go in there to spawn. So you can just go out blind without electronics and just put lures out and start trolling. And of course, if you start catching fish, you want to make a loop and you want to kind of stay in that area. Because if you find an area that's got fish, you want to stay in it. But electronics are fun to sit and watch while you're trolling, waiting for that rod to start singing. It's fun. Anyway, I have Lowrance and I also have Helix. Hummingbird Helix 10, and I have a 7 I put on the front of the boat for crappie fishing. It's not on the boat now, but here's the Hummingbird Helix 10. My Lowrance Hook 9, I use the Navionics. I've got the Lake Master on the Hummingbird. I use the Lake Master with my trolling motor. I've got the Link system with the Ultera. I like using that with this, but I'm so used to the Navionics, because that's what I had gotten first, was the Navionics with the Lowrance. I like the outline better, the color of, if you see the main channel, the river that used to be before the lake was dammed up, they show it really nice. I really like that. If you go to the Hummingbird, I'll show you the difference that I don't like. You can see the river somewhat, but you see how pronounced, defined that is? That's why I like the Navionics. Trolling speed, when you get up into the 3.5 mile an hour, you got to figure the fish out. They're finicky. Usually when I start fishing, I always start fishing live bait. If the fish are biting real finicky, grabbing the line, pulling the rod down and popping back, that means they're finicky. And if you start trolling lures and you pull them at a faster speed, when fish come up to whack that bait, not necessarily to eat it, they're coming up just because their natural reactions, they go up and blast at it to try and kill it, even though they may not want to eat it. Well, that scenario, I catch most of my fish in the eye, the back of the head, outside the mouth. You're snagging most of them with the treble hooks on the lure. So that's a key. If you're getting finicky bites, because I'll even be trolling lures, if I'm trolling a slower speed, and I see the rod bend over and pop back up, I'll pick this pace up to get them to be more aggressive at coming faster at it, give them more chance to get, unfortunately, snagged. You're not catching them in the mouth. A lot of them you will catch in the mouth, but you'll see that you catch a lot of them, you foul hook them. And of course, if you foul hook them just right in the back, it can feel like a big one. Now, when it comes to your boat, you always want to make your boat as comfortable as can be. Take people out fishing, they want to relax and they want to have a good time and they want to catch fish. You get somebody that's tired from reeling fish in all day, they can lay down, take a nap. You got nice captain's chairs, they can sit back here, or up here in the front of the boat, and they can relax and look back. 90% of my fishing is done off the back of the boat, so this is a comfortable spot to sit and watch the rods. You gotta keep an eye on the rods, especially when you're live bait fishing. You wanna watch them rods. You wanna see them bend over. And if they're aggressive and it's a decent size, they'll pull drag and a clicker will go off and it's exciting. Again, at the end of the trip, we like to go home, everything clean, no mess. I clean the fish right here on the boat. I got a cleaning station here with a tackle station. Got water, got electric power with an inverter for my electric fillet knives. Also can fillet fish back here. Also have water back here. Inverter is actually back here. Plug in electric fillet knife and fillet fish here. And up there at that station, I have a tackle station here as well. Trying to make everything convenient. More storage under there. All my switches are conveniently located here. Got washdown switch. Got all my live well switches. Light switches for night fishing. Got the outside of the boat set up with lights for crappie fishing, cat fishing. Stereo. Nice feature. You always want to have a nice stereo system, Bluetooth. You can listen to Pandora or your own music. I'm listening to my own music right now. I have a little tunes playing. I've got some fishing music that I love to play when I'm out here. Captain Sam Crutchfield, if anybody's familiar with him. Have your system set up where you can have music on nice and low. Another thing I do with my electronics, most guys don't put the fish ID on. Lowrance doesn't have a very good system, but you need to utilize the technology that they're putting into this. If they put the technology in here to recognize fish, even though I know those are fish, and they don't always mark a fish on there, it's nice to use that technology, and it puts it right at the depth that the fish is at. You don't have to try and look across your screen. Well, this one's easy because they're right here, but usually when it's full screen, you gotta look way over to get an idea. I utilize that. Hummingbird's got a better system than Lowrance. Like I say, most guys do not use that. I like it. I had this one turned on. I usually leave it turned off because it's about useless. Again, you do not have to turn it on. I like to utilize it. Like I say, it's personal preference. But gar, little old gar, that don't look good. I ain't even got my pliers out. Woo! That's what we were looking for. Begging. I'm begging. Come to Papa. Woo, baby, that's a begging. That's a begging. Ooh, that's a bigger. Man, he's a bigger. Oh, it had to be a big gar. Double header.
Yeah.
Get him. All right, where's mine at? There he is, triple header.
Triple header, baby.
That's what I'm talking about.
Oh, I did that.
Another one on. Another one on, Dave.
Here we go.